Continue the topic. The output current is continue from 0 to pi plus alpha. Pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. The output current is the 0. Why? Because here the negative half cycle is the reach at the pi. In the source voltage, supply voltage at the pi time period, in the supply side, supply voltage waveform at the pi period. Then during the negative half cycle of the circuit, when the anode is negative with respect to the cathode, the thyristor is reverse bias. During the reverse bias condition, thyristor is does not conducting. So thyristor is act as a unidirectional divisor. Divided, it conduct in only one direction, either positive or either negative. So during the negative half cycle from pi to 2 pi plus 2 pi, pi to 2 pi, pi to 2 pi. So negative half cycle is a reaches the circuit. The anode is negative with respect to the cathode. During the pi to 2 pi period, in this time interval, the thyristor is a off state. But the output voltage is pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha is the 0. Pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha equal to 0. Why? Because from pi to pi plus alpha, the some voltage is the drop across the inductance. So this is the feed. So we have to observe the pi to pi plus alpha. So pi plus alpha to 2 pi, the output voltage and output current is the 0. Pi to 2 pi plus alpha and 2 pi and 2 pi plus alpha, output voltage is the 0. Why? Because the thyristor is next in time period, during the next half cycle, is reaches from 2 pi to 3 pi, 2 pi to 3 pi. Now during the positive half cycle, thyristor is, the anode is positive with respect to the cathode, the thyristor start to conducting, In this period also, we have to give the triggering pulses alpha, alpha equal to 30 degrees. So it will be start conducting from 2 pi plus alpha. So the output voltage equal to 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha. 2 pi plus alpha. This is the output voltage. At the 3 pi plus alpha, the negative half cycle is the reaches. During the negative half cycle of the circuit, the thyristor start, reverse bias is the reaches. So thyristor is the off state. Thyristor does not conducting. So here 3 pi to 3 pi plus alpha, because of inductance property, the voltage drop across the inductors. So 3 pi to 3 pi pal, 3 pi plus alpha, negative half cycle during the, during the negative side, magnitude is there. So obtained, and the load output voltage side, we have to observe by waveform. So 3 pi plus alpha to 4 pi. The negative half cycle reaches, the SCR does not conducting. Why? Because the SCR is negative with respect to the cathode. SCR of anode is negative with respect to the cathode. So the SCR is a reverse bias. Here SCR does not conducting. So output voltage is 0. Output current also 0. So the output current during the negative half cycle is 0 from 3 pi plus alpha to 4 pi. But and the next half cycle, 4 pi to 5 pi, the SCR, 4 pi to 4 pi plus alpha, SCR is does not conducting. Why? Because here we have to give the firing angle alpha, firing pulses alpha. firing angle alpha at applied at 4 pi plus alpha. So the SCR start conducting at during the next half cycle, during the next half cycle 4 pi plus alpha, the SCR is fired, the SCR is start conducting 4 pi plus alpha to 5 pi, 4 plus alpha to 5 pi. So here the SCR start to conducting, So the source will equal to load voltage, and the current also flowing through the load 4 pi plus alpha to 5 plus 5 pi plus alpha, 5 pi plus alpha. Here observe that, once again I am repeating, during the positive half cycle the SCR is start conducting from alpha to pi. This is during the positive half cycle, 0 to pi actually, positive half cycle. The output voltage is obtained from alpha to pi plus alpha, pi plus alpha, alpha to pi plus alpha. Why? Because pi to pi plus alpha, here because of inductance property, the voltage drop across the inductance. So the negative magnitude, negative side, the magnitude is the appearance from pi to pi plus alpha. Alpha to pi is the source, positive half cycle you have to apply it, then SCR is the start conducting, source voltage equal to load voltage. Next, at the pi to 2 pi, the supply voltage side, and we have to observe supply voltage, pi to 2 pi, negative half cycle is reaches, the SCR does not conducting. So the output voltage is the zero, from pi plus alpha, output voltage, load voltage side and output voltage side, pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha, output voltage is the zero. Why? Because the at the 2 pi time period, negative half cycle is the reaches, positive half cycle is the reaches. So the SCR start to conducting from pi, 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha. So this is the continuous time period is a, you have to obtain the output voltage, and output current and the load current is flowing through the load alpha to pi plus alpha, alpha to pi plus alpha. Here the SCR start conducting, so the current flowing through the load is the alpha to pi plus alpha, and 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha. During that pi plus 2 pi to 2 pi plus alpha, here does SCR does not conducting. Why? Because here firing pulses you have to apply it. Firing pulses is given to the SCR by using external triggering circuit. At 2 pi to 2 pi plus 2 pi plus alpha, firing pulses is given. So here SCR is a does not conducting. Why? Because suppose we have to given the firing pulses by using the alpha equal to 30 degree, SCR is start conducting at delay angle of alpha. So here does not appearance on load voltage and output voltage side is a zero. Load voltage and output current is a zero in this time period, pi to pi plus alpha. Next, at the 2 pi plus alpha, the current is a flowing through the load. Why? Because SCR is a start conducting during the positive half cycle, 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha, till 3 pi plus alpha, 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha is current flowing through the load. Why? Because during the positive half cycle of the SCR is start to conducting, but 3 pi plus, just 3 pi, the during the positive half cycle, 2 pi to 3 pi only, but 3 pi plus alpha, here the energy stored the inductance, so it is the drop the voltage, so the current is the flowing slightly from 3 pi to 3 pi plus alpha. At 3 pi plus alpha to 4 pi plus alpha, output voltage is 0 and output current also zero. Why? Because here negative half cycle reaches. So then during the negative half cycle, SCR is the not conducting, the SCR is the reverse bias, so SCR is the does not conducting, so the output voltage and output current is the zero. In the resistive load, the only we have to obtain the output voltage and output current from alpha to pi, from alpha to pi. But here alpha to pi plus alpha is the output voltage. Alpha to pi plus alpha, that is the output voltage and output current. Why? Because here we have to insert the inductance load. You have to insert the inductance load that depends on the inductance property and store the electrical energy in the form of EMF. So this this time interval is a continuous within 1 second in the 50 cycle. In the 50 cycle, you have to obtain that this is the last one is the voltage across the thyristors. Voltage across the thyristors from 0 to alpha, the voltage drop here across the SCR. Why? Because here SCR is a does not conducting. Alpha to 2 pi plus alpha, SCR here conducting. So there is no voltage drop across the SCR. From 0 to alpha, here the voltage drop across the SCR. So the output voltage is appearance across the voltage across the thyristor. So next alpha to 2 pi, alpha to pi plus alpha, the output voltage is the 0. Voltage across the thyristor is the 0. Why? Because here SCR is the conducting. And pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. Here the SCR is the does not conducting. SCR is the off state. So the voltage drop across the SCR. So we have to shown in the waveform pi plus alpha to 2 pi plus alpha. Next, and 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi plus alpha, the SCR is the start conducting during the positive half cycle. So there is no voltage drop across the SCR. And 3 pi plus alpha to 4 pi plus alpha, SCR is does not conducting. So the voltage drop across the SCR here. So this is the voltage drop across the SCR and load voltage and load current and supply voltage. This is the output waveform for corresponding this circuit. The only one point is there here. During the positive half cycle, SCR just start conducting. So the source will equal to load voltage and load current is flowing. During the SCR is during the positive half cycle. Why? Because during the positive half cycle, SCR is the turn on. Only one point. Next, during the negative half cycle, the SCR is the turn off. Why? Because during the negative half cycle, SCR is the turn off at in reverse bias. SCR is the turn off. So output voltage and output current is a 0. But we have to remember that here we have to introduce the inductance. The inductance is act as a energy storing devices. So depend upon this principle, the pi to pi plus alpha and 3 pi to 3 pi plus alpha, the negative half cycle is a reaches the negative half cycle negative side magnitude is appearance. So this is called the depends on the principle of inductance, in the properties of inductance. Inductance act as a energy storing devices. So you drop the voltage. So we have to output voltage and load voltage side, we have to observe the waveform pi to pi plus alpha and 3 pi to 3 pi plus alpha. And current also same, the current flowing through the load pi to pi plus alpha and 3 pi to 3 pi plus alpha. So continuous current flows. So this is a continuous cycle here, flows within 1 second. The 50 half cycle is flowing within 1 cycle. This is the principal operation. Next, this is the operation of waveform and operation of circuits. This is also single phase half wave full control converter. Single phase half wave fully control converter. Half a control or not fully control. From the waveform, it is clear that the load current is driven by the load voltage from alpha to pi, from pi to beta, pi to beta or pi to pi plus alpha, pi to beta or pi plus alpha, pi plus alpha. The load voltage is negative and load current is maintained by inductance. After omega t equal to pi plus alpha or beta, output voltage and output current is a zero. At omega t equal to 2 pi plus alpha, the thyristor is triggered again. The output voltage is applied to the load and load current is developed as before. So all this is called as the, just we have to explain already. So the beta is called as extension angle or pi plus alpha or beta, pi plus alpha or beta. Beta minus alpha equal to gamma is called as a conduction angle, is called as a conduction angle. So this is the conduction angle. Conduction angle in the waveform is nothing but pi to pi plus alpha, pi to pi plus alpha, pi to conduction angle is gamma is equal to beta minus alpha, beta minus alpha. That is called the conduction angle. The waveform of voltage across the thyristors reveal that when the omega t equal to alpha, the voltage across the thyristor is equal to Vm sin alpha. From alpha to beta, Vt equal to 0. We have to observe in the waveform. Alpha to beta, output voltage is 0, voltage across the thyristors. Alpha to beta or alpha to pi plus alpha, voltage across the thyristor. Voltage across the thyristor, alpha equal alpha, alpha equal to alpha to beta, voltage is 0. At beta, voltage across the Vm sin beta. Vm sin beta. So turn off time, the thyristor is reversed bias. Thyristor is reversed bias at 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi, at 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi. So here the reverse bias for 2 pi minus beta or 2 pi minus 2 pi plus alpha, the radian, the conduct, the circuit turn off time, the circuit turn off time TC is equal to 2 pi minus beta by omega, where omega equal to angular frequency equal to 2 pi plus 2 pi f, 2 pi f, where omega equal to 2 pi f, where f is the supply frequency, supply frequency. The average output voltage, the average output voltage, the average output voltage, the average output voltage is equal to the magnitude of average output voltage, the average output voltage, the magnitude of output voltage, V out voltage, load voltage and load current. The what is the value of output voltage and what is the value of output current, we have to calculate from the figure. Output voltage equal to, we have to take in the complete one cycle, 1 by 2 pi, 1 by 2 pi, the integration equal to alpha to beta, integration 1 by 1 alpha to beta, alpha means alpha to beta means pi plus alpha, beta means pi plus alpha. Then V out equal to 1 by 2 pi alpha to beta Vm sin omega t d omega t, Vm sin omega t d omega t. So Vm by 2 pi, then after simplification, then we have to got the output voltage equal to Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus cos beta, cos alpha minus cos beta. The average load current is equal to output current is equal to output voltage by resistance and inductance, resistance and inductance. So the output voltage Vm by 2 pi or cos alpha minus cos beta, cos alpha minus cos beta. So this is the output current, and output power equal to, output power is equal to V out by V out into I out, V out into I out, and this is the average output voltage and average output current, output voltage and average output current. Next, here it is clear that we have to observe the output voltage and output current in the corresponding waveform for the this circuit, corresponding waveform for this circuits. We have to calculate the value of output voltage from alpha to pi plus alpha, pi plus alpha at the point of pi plus alpha is equal to beta, that is equal to beta. So we have to here represented with the beta, beta is called as the extension angle. Beta is called as the extension angle. The extension angle is obtained depends on the property of inductance. It inductance acts as the energy storing device. During the negative half cycle, the SR is a turn off, but it store the energy. It store the energy till the SCR turn off. So pi 2 pi plus alpha pi 2 beta or pi 2 pi plus alpha or beta. So this is called as the extension angle. The load current also flowing through the load from alpha to pi plus alpha or beta. Pi plus alpha or beta. Only one point is there, principal operation. Just SCR is same as resistive load. The SCR is start conducting alpha to pi. At the pi, negative half cycle reaches. The SCR is the turn off. But extension angle pi to beta or pi plus alpha, this magnitude you have to obtain from depends on the inductance. Inductance acts as the energy storing devices. When the negative half cycle is the reaches, during the positive half cycle, energy is the stored the inductance. When negative half cycle is the reaches, the SCR does not turn off immediately. So we have to obtain the negative half cycle. You have to obtain the negative half cycle pi to pi plus alpha here, because it feed to the energy from the inductance, feed the energy from the inductance. Then during the negative half cycle, the SCR is turned off at pi plus alpha, at the beta. So at the beta to 2 pi, during the negative half cycle, SCR is a turn off. At the 2 pi, the SCR start to conducting. Why? Because here positive half cycle is the reaches. So here the SCR does not conducting immediate at the 2 pi. Why? Because here firing pulses is given 2 pi plus alpha at the time period 2 pi plus alpha firing pulses is given. The SCR is start conducting 2 pi plus alpha to 3 pi. 3 pi plus alpha to 3 pi. And 3 pi to 3 pi plus alpha. SCR also turn off, but it store the inductance property. The negative side, some magnitude is the reaches. That is called the extension angle. And it is voltage is drop across the inductance. The current also flowing through the load from pi to pi plus alpha and 3 pi to 3 pi plus alpha. So that is the only one point we have to observe. Next, we have to discuss the effect of load inductance and working principle of single phase half wave control converter with RL load and voltage and current waveform and load voltage and load current expression. The some quiz questions is there here. In case of single phase half wave control converter with RL load at omega t pi, output voltage is zero but current is does not zero due to the properties of inductance. The option A is inductance, option B is resistance. What the answer is? Nothing but here option A, inductance is correct answer. In case of single phase half wave control converter with RL load at omega t is equal to pi, output voltage is zero but output current does not zero due to inductance property. That is the option A is correct answer. Next question. The thyristor is dash biased from beta to 2 pi plus alpha. Beta means pi plus alpha to 2 pi. The SCR is reverse bias. So here the answer is nothing but the option A, reverse bias. Option A, SCR is reverse bias. That is the option A is the correct. Third question. The average load voltage, output voltage of single phase half wave control converter with RL load is given by output voltage only, not output current here. the question is asking the average load output voltage of single phase half wave control converter with resistance inductance load is given by Vm by 2 pi 1 plus cos alpha, or option A, and option B is nothing but Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus cos beta. Option B is correct answer. That is Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus cos beta. We have to derive an expression from output average output voltage. That is the Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus cos beta. That is the output voltage. Output voltage equal to Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus cos beta. This is the correct answer. Next, the important questions. The question is asking from the this topic, these types of question. The explain the working of single phase half wave control converter, not full control, only half control converter with RL load. Draw the output waveform. So here working with the circuit diagram here. So we have to draw the circuit diagram and waveform. You draw the circuit diagram and waveform, and we have to explain the principle and working principle of circuit diagram and waveform. Next question: What is the effect of inductance in case of single phase half wave control converter with RL load? What are the effect and inductance of nothing but the extension angle is obtained in the load output side, and current is flowing from 0 to pi plus alpha and pi plus alpha or beta, pi to alpha to beta. Why? Because here inductance is nothing but energy storing devices. Next, derive an expression for output voltage and output current of single phase half wave control converter with resistance and inductance load is nothing but V output equal to Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus cos beta, and average load current equal to I naught is equal to Vm by 2 pi R cos alpha minus cos beta. This is the three questions. This is a circuit diagram, and this is the waveform. The difference between the resistance load and inductance load, only extension angle, and the current through the load is flowing from pi to beta here, but alpha to beta here. But in resistance load, only alpha to pi. Resistance load alpha to pi, and load current voltage also same thing, and output current also same. In resistance load alpha to pi only, output voltage and output current is flowing through the load. Output voltage across the load is pi alpha to pi in resistance load, and output current alpha to pi in resistance load. But here output load and output current in inductance load alpha to beta, and output current and output voltage also alpha to beta. Here the extension angle is why? because of presence of effect of inductance. So this is the difference between the resistance load and inductance load. In the resistance load there is no extension angle, but inductance load they have extension angle from alpha pi to beta, and output current equal to alpha to beta. So this is the difference between the resistance load and inductance load. So any doubt, we have to read. This is the complete principle. Read the complete principle, the operating principle. So we have to clear that. This is the circuit diagram. Single phase half wave control converter. Here, that meaning of this sentence is nothing but single phase, we have to operate the single by using a single phase source and only half control converter, half wave only control converter, not full wave, only half wave we have to control the converter. So single phase half wave control converter. Here the output voltage in output side, only half cycle is the controlling, so depend upon the magnitude of output voltage, firing angle of alpha, if firing angle of alpha is the increases, the average output voltage is the decreases, so the output voltage, the average output voltage is depends on firing angle of alpha. So firing angle is increases, average output voltage is the decreases, and current also decreases, so we have to control the output voltage, so by using the SCR we have to conversion and controlling, this is the quiz, some quiz question is there, the most important for the computer exam. This is the first question, the second question, and this is the third questions. By note down the these two equation most important, the average output voltage, of single phase half wave control converter with RL load, Vm by 2 pi cos alpha minus cos beta. Suppose I not equal to Vm by 2 pi R cos alpha minus cos beta. The during the forward bias condition, the SCR is the conducting. During the reverse bias condition, SCR is the does not conducting. So beta to 2 pi means here the SCR does not conducting. So here reverse bias. The SCR is the reverse bias. Answer is SCR reverse bias. Here the output voltage is a zero, but I not not zero due to the presence of inductance. Okay, thank you.